الحمد لله الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين صدق الله العظيم. Respected viewers and listeners, we begin by praising Almighty Allah for granting us a most comprehensive and a most beautiful deen which He has chosen for humanity, says Allah, وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينَ. We send salutations upon our beloved Nabi Kareem, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Continuing with our series on purification of the heart. Now, we're starting off after speaking about riya, ostentation, then jealousy, and then pride. Now we're starting off on something. Before we start on that spiritual disease, and something to do with the heart, let me give you a small introduction. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created within us certain emotions, certain instincts. Some are natural, like hunger and thirst. Some are positive, kindness, compassion, mercy, which Allah ta'ala has kept in every human being. Some have propensity for harm, some greater than others. But in terms of harms to human relationship, this calamity and affliction and disease that I'm going to be speaking about, and of course the disease, if it is not controlled, is perhaps one of the greatest and one of the most hurtful and harmful for human relationships, and that is anger. And many people have given an example of anger known as ghadab in the Arabic language, of a swelling ocean which is very difficult to control when unleashed. And we know and we all understand the harm with regard to anger in terms of human relationships. For example, how many people's lives have been destroyed by words or sentences which were uttered in a fit of rage and anger. And thereafter it's very difficult to bring it back. How someone had said most beautifully that I'm a master of what I have not said and I'm a slave of what I have said. So in anger, no matter how much you regret it, you have to sometimes live by the consequences of what you say. How many people have become estranged, have been discarded by their family and society because of not being able to control their anger? How many people have been offended by words which have been uttered by anger? So there is no doubt with regard to the aspect with regard to being very, very harmful. Therefore, one day a person came to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, Ya Rasulullah, give me advice. And Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him three times, La taghdab, la taghdab, la taghdab. Don't become angry, don't become angry. Perhaps he was amongst those who was prone to anger or who could not control his anger. Therefore, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him that advice which was most appropriate for him. Now, very interesting is that anger is not necessarily all negative. It's not necessarily only a negative emotion. It becomes negative when it is not controlled and not channeled, as I will go on to say. But it is part and parcel of our makeup. It's an instinct with which we are growing. And it can be a very, very positive motivator. Without anger, how will we be motivated to protect our interest? How will we be motivated to respect our honor? How will we be motivated to protect our assets, our respect, our honor? How will we be able to be getting the right type of attitude to resist injustice and wrong? Allah Ta'ala in the Holy Quran says, "Jahid al-kuffara wal-munafiqina waghluz alayhim." Strive against those people who are on falsehood and be stern against them. How will that happen if there is no anger? And therefore we find in the words of the hadith and in the example of our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they used to get angry, especially for considerations of truth and justice and haq. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam never, the sahaba say that, never got angry for his own personal reasons. He used to get angry for the sake and for considerations of truth and justice. And sometimes when he used to get angry, there used to be a vein that used to protrude between his two eyes, between the eyebrows, and people used to see it, and his, you know, cheeks used to be flushed with redness. And in one riwayat, so amazingly, They say it was as if pomegranate was squeezed upon the face of our beloved Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Umar radiallahu ta'ala's anger for the sake of truth and justice is well known. Ashadduhum fi amrillahi Umar. Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, the one who is most stern and strong upon the commands of Allah Ta'ala is Umar. And who can forget that most remarkable incident of Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, which has been made mention in the books of history, that he was fighting in the cause of fighting, and he overwhelmed a person who was a combatant, not a non-combatant, a combatant, someone who was in the war, and he had set upon him and he had overwhelmed him, and he was about to finish him, he was about to complete the aspect of killing him in the battlefield, and all of a sudden the person spat upon the face of Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he got up, and the person was just taken aback, and he said, you had me under your control. It was not as if this was an unfair or an unjust type of thing. It was a war. If I had the opportunity, I would have done the same thing to you. What made you do this? He said, I was fighting with you for the sake of Allah. Now that you spat upon me, I saw personal considerations coming into the play, and therefore I withdrew. Subhanallah, that is a situation. Imam Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi so beautifully said that anger, right, is correct with the right time, at the right time, at the right place, with the right reasons, with the right intensity. Let me repeat that. Anger can be positive if it is at the right time, the right place, the right reason, with the right intensity. And there is no greater example in this than the example of our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In every matter, he was an ideal. We know minutest details with regard to the life of our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We know that he used to get angry. We also know that sometimes those anger used to be upon his face. But we never ever know that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam lost himself in anger, or he did something that was rash or imprudent. And that is the example that we have to follow. May Allah Ta'ala give us a tawfiq as we will continue with us in the coming days. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.